Scuba divers love a good debate. Din versus yoke, aluminum versus steel, jacket versus back inflate, and indeed split fins versus paddle fins. And we're going to try and settle that dispute in this episode of Scuba Science. Are split fins indeed a modern marvel of engineering and the king of efficiency? Or are paddle fins those trusted and proven workhorses? That's what we're going to settle in today's episode of Scuba Science. This program is completely self-funded and you can support Scuba Science by liking the video, leaving a comment, recommending it to your friends, subscribing to the Dive Saga channel, and you can also join. There is a join button, it allows you to become a member, and Dive Saga All Access members do also get access to the Scuba Science scripts for future reference and to some of the Dive Saga soundtrack. So that's a great way to support Dive Saga and Scuba Science. Before we can get started, let's be very clear about what we are discussing. We are discussing paddle fins versus split fins. Paddle fins are indeed basically the solid traditional full blade fins, typically made from one piece of material pushing water backwards. Split fins are essentially engineered fins that typically have a slit in the middle. As if someone took a knife, took a paddle fin and cut a V-shape right out of the middle of the blade. And that split obviously isn't cosmetic, it's there to change the flow of water as you kick. So which of the two is better? Since split fins are relatively newer than paddle fins, you would think that there is a reason for that innovation, and that split fins are, of course, in any case, the better solution. So here's where it gets interesting, because in order to decide which of those two fin designs is the better one, we simply have to evaluate what the physics are behind the movements we make and the propulsion that they cause. Paddle fins work like a traditional paddle, which is why I've been calling them paddle fins and not full fins. They very much work like, let's say, a kayak paddle that you stick into the water and just push the water backwards. It's a concept as old as time and it absolutely does work. The bigger and stiffer the blade, the more water you will simply move backwards with each movement. Moving more water backwards means generating more thrust. Split fins, on the other hand, are inspired by the way fishtails work. As you kick, water moves through the split and generates a vortex behind each side of the split. So instead of just moving one big block of water, you're actually generating two little jets. They're smaller, but also considerably faster. And the result of that is, of course, less resistance on your legs and therefore an increased efficiency. At least under certain very specific conditions. So which one is better? Because split fins excel in efficiency, but paddle fins excel in raw power. And so it does become a question of efficiency versus power. They at first glance might sound like the same thing, but they are not. If you flutter kick with split fins in calm conditions, you are reducing the drag on your legs. And many divers report feeling less fatigued, less strained on the joints, and simply having an easier time kicking. But as mentioned, on the condition that you flutter kick and in gentle conditions. On the other hand, when you need to accelerate or hold your position in a strong current or make complicated maneuvers, the paddle fin is going to be a lot more powerful to achieve that. That's because they push back this big amount of water. So in other words, they're able to generate brute force in a way that split fins simply can't. And that really brings us to technique. It is really not fair to have a discussion about which of these fins is better without discussing the proper techniques to use with each fin and the techniques that you may be using more or less frequently in your specific diving scenarios. Split fins are really typically designed for flutter kicking. That steady up and down kick makes them at their most efficient. You may have noticed this when you, for instance, tried backfinning with a split fin you will have a significantly harder time than doing that with a paddle fin. But for those divers who are doing simply that, just flutter kicking in calm waters, split fins are a clear winner. Paddle fins, on the other hand, are versatile. They're very suitable for frog kicking, back kicking, helicopter turning. That's why they're often preferred by divers who have to maneuver in tight spaces such as wrecks and caves. So again, it really does become a question of which environment you're most likely to find yourself in and which finning technique you're then more likely to use to negotiate that environment. There actually have been some scientific studies on this topic, believe it or not, and that's actually useful to sort of help us settle this debate. The US Navy, for instance, no surprise, has conducted some tests on this subject and has concluded that indeed jet fins create significantly less power than paddle fins. However, other research has proven that divers with split fins actually consume significantly less gas when they are propelling themselves through the water. So again, there it depends a little bit what you value more. But in conclusion there as well, the lab actually simply confirms what divers already intuitively feel. Split fins are much more easygoing on the legs, but paddle fins are simply stronger. So it seems appropriate that we try to bust or confirm a couple of myths in regards to split fins versus paddle fins. Myth number one, and as a scuba instructor, I hear this all the time, split fins are faster. That's not true. In most head-to-head races, paddle fins come out significantly faster than split fins. Myth number two, split fins are always easier to work with. That's also not entirely true, because a lot of modern paddle fins will have channels and vents and some types of engineering that also significantly reduce the work that is required to operate these fins while still delivering significant power. And myth number three is, of course, that one type is always better than the other. That's the whole point of this video, is sort of settling a debate, split fins versus paddle fins. And of course, that myth is also not true. The truth lies somewhere in the middle. More specifically, which conditions do you dive in and which finning techniques are you likely to use most? So that brings us to the point, how do you choose your split fin versus your paddle fin? I get these questions so often, especially on our Dive Saga Instagram page, people just asking for equipment recommendations, which one is better? Unfortunately, the answer is so much more nuanced than just a simple recommendation of a brand name and a fin type. If you're a recreational warm water diver who is just going to be flutter kicking in very, very mild environments, then yeah, split fins are probably going to be a better solution for you, especially if you want to have long life on your ankle joints. On the other hand, if you're going to dive in strong currents, cold water, or with bulky gear, then paddle fins are probably simply going to give you more bang for your buck, because you're simply going to have to work harder, so you might as well just generate more power as you're doing that. For technical divers, or perhaps wreck or cave divers, where maneuvering becomes a lot more important, paddle fins are probably also going to be your best bet. They're going to give you the precision that is needed to maneuver in these tight environments. For divers who are maybe a little older or who have some joint issues, there again, split fins are probably going to offer some relief over the paddle fins. I would also say that it does depend on the type of exposure protection that you are wearing. If you are wearing, for instance, a dry suit, you'll probably want some significant weight on your feet, and generally speaking, paddle fins are simply going to provide a little bit more weight. So that's just another thing to consider. So which is better, split fins or paddle fins? It really does depend. Both designs really are brilliant solutions, but to different problems. If comfort and efficiency are your priority, go split, absolutely no problem. If power, versatility, and control are more important to you, go paddle fin. The real answer, and this is also just the art of mastery in diving, is to match the tool to the job. It's a bit like putting race tires on a car that is going to go out in the snow. It's not going to be very efficient, you're not going to have a great time controlling the car, and you might even get in an accident. The best fin is the one that's designed for the conditions that you're planning to dive in. So I'm kind of curious, what fins do you dive with? But more importantly, why? Let me know that in the comments. Match your type of fins with your type of conditions and let's see if there is a correlation there. Remember that you can always subscribe to the Dive Saga channel and you can become a Dive Saga All Access member. I also want to thank our current Dive Saga members for supporting the channel. It's not unlikely that I'll have to make an update to this video as we get new fin types coming out as more progress is being made in the field of scuba science.